So, Buddha bears had a very interesting week. First of all, I've been hired as Buddha bear's secretary because there's, several emails and different things that Buddha bear receives. So one is a letter here from Bodhi bear. And Bodhi bear lives in Virginia. And Bodhi Bear wrote this letter to Buddha Bear. So Bodhi Bear says, "Dear Buddha Bear, my name is Bodhi Bear, a bodhisattva in training. You have brought such great joy to so many, and I would like to be your friend." It's a nice compliment, huh? "I will be sending a photo of Buddha and me when the nice lady that I live with learns how. She's totally clueless when it comes to cell phone technology." Yeah, your secretary has that same problem. "I've enclosed a special treat for you to share with the Abbey. I look forward to watching your next lesson with venerable children. Lots of love and bear hugs, Bodhi Bear." So, here's your present. Gummy bears. Look, they're red and green and clear and orange and yellow. And here are sour gummy bears with all kinds of speckled stuff on them. Yeah? So you, boy, you have a whole brand already. Yeah? So these are the gummy bears, and you're going to start, I think, the Buddha bears. Yeah? Made Buddha bear chocolate. What do you think? Okay. But in the meantime, these are for you to give to the rest of the Abbey. Okay. Then the second communication was, you remember Bodhi Bug came and visited you a couple of weeks ago? Yeah, so we got an email from Venerable Jompa. Everybody in the Hamburg Center was so amazed how fast Bodhi Bug flew from Hamburg to the Abbey 2 weeks ago, and how fast Bodhi Bug returned to Hamburg. But Bodhi Bug has more to say. Okay, so let's see if we can, send out some message to Bodhi Bug that he's got to come here, and now's the time to tell you the message from Venerable Jompa and the people at the Hamburg Center. Yeah? Ready? Okay, listen well. Oh my goodness.
I just got here from Hamburg.
Oh. Oh, you sound really tired, Bodhi Bug.
Yeah, it's a long flight.
Yeah.
Yeah, takes a long time, but I'm quick.
I think it was only 5 minutes.
Yeah, well, I'm a super fast flying bug.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So your friend really wants to see you.
Hi, Bodhi Bug.
Hey, Buddha Bear.
Welcome back.
Thank you. So, I was thinking more about what we talked about last time. I'm so glad that you're refraining from eating bugs, like me and my family. I feel safe around you, which is rare for bugs in the world, you know? Thank you.
It's really quite a delight. I've been in the garden and seen some of the grubs and little animals and think of them like more like brothers and sisters.
Oh, thank you, Buddha Bear. Thank you for caring about bugs.
Now I love bugs in a different way. Not so much love to eat them, but love them as fellow beings.
Thank you. Well, I was talking to my aunt, Frida Fly. She's interested in genealogy. She said that we're losing our species because of the pesticides that some humans use. You don't use pesticides at the Abbey, do you?
No, we like pests.
Oh, good. Thank you. Yeah, insects are dying out at alarming rates. And you know what? I heard from my friend Buzz that bees and butterflies are also having a hard time. Yeah, it's real sad. I think humans would be real concerned if they were dying out like this, don't you think?
Yeah.
Buddha bear.
Yeah, it's really sad to hear. It's kind of like the problem with the bears. We're having a hard time too, like the bugs.
You are?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. But you know, without us bugs, people wouldn't have coffee. I mean, you don't have coffee at the Abbey anyway. But they wouldn't have honey or fruit or milk or cotton or silk clothing. You know what? They wouldn't even have chocolate.
Wow, that would really cause a lot of humans to die, probably.
Yeah. I know some humans love their chocolate.
I love chocolate.
Yeah, I know you do.
I love Buddha gummies, Bear. Too. I'm excited about these gummies. They're my favorite.
So, sadly, these humans don't think a lot about the planet, you know? But I think we all have a precious opportunity, you know, us bears and bugs, you know, to practice the Dharma. So, I overheard a teaching one Thursday, and there was this master, and he quoted the Buddha, and he said that if they bring forth strength of perseverance, even bees and flies and gnats and grubs will gain supreme enlightenment, so hard to find. So that's me!
Yeah, you know, I don't think it's just a mere coincidence that bear and bug and Buddha all start with the letter B. We have the potential to become Buddhas.
Yeah, bears and bugs and Buddhas.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can do it.
Yeah. Especially when we work together and help each other. And, you know, when we work together, it's hard to say the impact that we can have, because then others who don't normally work together might be inspired to also find their commonalities and see that they really have a kind heart that wants to support others.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree, Buddha Bear. Yeah, you're real smart.
You
I
too.
Like you. So, I really appreciate what you're doing and what the Abbey's doing too. But how are we going to inspire others to do like we're doing and to do like the Abbey's doing? You know? How are we going to do it? How are we going to get them to expand their heart? What do you think, Buddha Bear?
Well, there's one thing that I like to do.
Yeah? What's that?
I like to do some visualizations and chant Namo Amitofo.
I know you do, Buddha Bear.
Think about the Buddha's radiant light coming down and inspiring my mind to really cultivate that equanimous love for all beings, including the bugs.
Ooh, that sounds real fun.
Yeah. Okay. Do you like to chant?
Yes.
Okay, let's do it.
Woo!
Namo Amitabha.
Oh,
Namo
Amitabha. Namo Amitabha. Namo Amitabha.
Thank you.